As we all know, logging mechanism is very crucial features in real-time development. Because using log file, a developer can easily track the root cause of any failure, and which will save bunch of time for a developer, isn't it? Let me show you one sample logging example so that you guys can understand it in better way. So here I developed one CRUD application where I have two REST endpoints. One will save list of product and another one will fetch list of product from database. So if you observe here, I just want to capture the input request I am getting from the user interface, and here I added log statement to capture the response I am getting back from service. Similarly, in get products, I wrote the log statement to display the records I am getting from database. Okay. The way we wrote log statement in our controller, same way you need to write log statement in your service, in your repository, whatever the layer you are using in your application. In real time, you need to write this log statement in each and every layer so that easily you can track the flow of your application using this log statement. But sometimes you will find more log statement in your code as compared to your actual business code. So if you observe in this method, I have one line business code who will add the product in our service, and service will call the database. But for that, I wrote two line of log statement. Okay. So it's kind of code smell, we can say. So now we need to think how we can avoid this code smell. How I can decouple this log statement from my application. For that, we can go for Spring AOP. I guess you guys know what is AOP and why we are using it. So I'm not going to explain in depth about this Spring AOP concept, but still let me give some basic overview what exactly this Spring AOP. So AOP stands for Aspect Oriented Programming Language, who will help us to segregate with your business logic to secondary logic. As I told you, this log statement is my secondary logic, because without this log statement, my actual business code can be executed. Only we are adding this log statement to track the application flow, isn't it? So then how I can segregate this primary logic from this secondary logic using Spring AOP? So that's what we are going to learn in this tutorial. So we are going to centralize our logging mechanism. Instead of writing log statement in code, we can write in some different layer so that the logging features can be applicable for my application. Okay, so let's understand same useful example with code. Let's get started. So first, let me remove this log statement from code, as we are not going to write in our application. For that, we are going to create a new layer. Okay. So let's remove from this getProducts method. Yeah. So create a new package. Let me copy the package name. Let's say the package name is advice. So here create a class, something like logging advice. Need to annotate this class with @aspect. So let me check whether we added Spring AOP dependency or not. Data.jpa web dev tools h2. Yeah, so we need to add the Spring AOP dependency here. So let me copy it. So let's add it. So we don't want the version. This will be managed by Spring Auto Configuration. Yeah. So here we add annotate @aspect, and we need to annotate this class with @component. Okay. Then let's write a method. Let's say public and specify the return type object and application logger. Here in method argument, we need to pass proceeding join point. So this proceeding join point, if you observe, this is came from the AOP. Okay. Internally, this proceeding join point using the reflection so that you can get the method details and what are the input parameter is coming to the my method. we can track this using this preceding join point. Okay, so let me show you. Let's I want to get the method name. Okay, so I can write something like preceding join point dot get signature. This will give the method name. Okay, dot signature dot get name. Similarly, if I want to get the class name, so I can type class name, then I will get it from preceding join point dot get target, something like that. Yeah, get target dot get class dot toString. As this preceding join point internally using the reflection API, so using that you can get the which method it is calling and which class it invoking, you can get to know using this preceding join point. Okay, so we get the method name and class name. Now we want what are the input is coming to my method, that also I want to capture. So for that we can do something like, let's say object array, and we'll get it from preceding join point dot get arguments. Now suppose I am invoking this controller method. Okay, so whatever the input is giving to this method can be captured by this get args. Okay, so we'll get to know once we'll add the log statement using this logging advice. Now we have all the required fields we have configured here, so we can go for the logger now. So instead of write the log statement in code, we can manage in this logging advice. Okay, so let me write the logger sl4j. We can create the instance of logger factory, then we need to give this class. So here using this log we can capture those fields, method name, class name and the input. So what we can do, let's write log dot info. So let's add the message here, something like method invoked, then from which class that we need to specify, then which method it is invoking. So we can specify the method name, and if there is any argument that we can keep track using this array which you will get from this preceding join point. So what I can do, let me format this message. This is what the method and this is my arguments. So let me specify arguments. Okay, so what we can do, we can convert this array or any object in proper JSON format. So for that I am using here object mapper. So you can simply write mapper, let me write, yeah, mapper dot write value as string. We just want to print this array in JSON format. Okay, so let me throw the exception. You can handle it, but let me throw it. Yeah, so let me zoom this class first. Yeah, so we added the log statement. This log statement will help. Let me show you. Suppose a person invoked this save product. So whatever the input you are getting and which class it is invoking and the method name, it will display with the help of this syntax. But I want to capture the response as well. Once this method execute, what exactly the response it is giving, that also I need to capture in my log. So this is what we are going to implement the around advice. Around advice is the combination of before advice and plus after returning advice, right? So before execute this method, I want to track the inputs, and after execute this method, I want to track the response. That's what we are going to implement this around advice for our log statement. So this will help us as a before advice, this particular statement, and I want to capture the response. So that's why once you will write preceding join point dot proceed, you will get the object, and that will be your return type. Okay, so once this method invoked, then only whatever the response you are getting from this method call, that you can capture here. Okay, so let me throw the exception. Yeah, and we can return this object as well, and we need to capture the response which we are getting after invoke this proceeding join point. So let me copy the same. So here we just want to display the response after invoke the method name. I just want to print the response here. So what we can do, let's format this log statement. Let me remove this method invoked. I just want to print only class name and method name. Then I want to name it response. Okay. And that response, I want to convert it in proper JSON format. So that's why I wrote write value as string. Okay. So this is what my entire method will take care about our log statement. So this will give you the before method invoked, what are the input and which method you are invoking. And once you call this particular line proceeding join point dot proceed, then you can capture the response which you will get from the service call. Okay. So I will show you with log statement so that it will be easy for you to understand. So we centralize our logging mechanism. Now how we'll inform to Spring AOP that this is what my controller class or this is what my method, I want to implement this logging statement. So for that, what we can do, there is a annotation provided by Spring AOP that is called point cut. We can use that. So the role of point cut will inform to Spring AOP who will be my actual target where I am going to implement this piece of code. Means our logging mechanism. Okay. Let's specify the point cut here. Let me write a method public void my point cut. Okay. So here we need to provide the point cut as a expression so that Spring AOP can understand, okay, this is the path where I need to implement this customized logging statement. Okay. So annotate here with point cut. So where is this annotation? Yeah. So what we can do here, we need to specify the value and we need to provide the path of your directory or the package or class or method where exactly you want to implement this AOP. So let's say, let me show you the directory. So if you observe here, I have, this is what up to my root directory. Then we have controller class, we have repository and we have service class. But here I want to implement this AOP concept across my application. So that's the reason. Let me take this root directory path. Then in logging advice in point cut, we can specify execution and where you want to exactly implement this AOP. So here in execution, I want to implement for any method, I does not worried about the return type, so that's why I keep it star. Then root directory path com javatechie spring dot aop dot api. Then inside that any package, any class, and for any method with n number of argument, I want to apply the logging mechanism. This is how we need to specify the point cut so that Spring AOP can understand where exactly he will implement this piece of code. Okay. Let's say you want to implement for only product controller. So what you can do, you need to give the path of this product controller. So like this, you can specify API, then my package is controller, then your class name, product controller. Then you need to specify the method name. Let's say in controller, we have the method called save products. Okay. So you can specify save products, but here I want to apply for all the layer, right? For controller, for service and for repository. That's why I don't want the package to specify here. I don't want class to specify here and I don't want method to specify here. Right. So we specify the point cut. Now we need to annotate here @around_advice. And in around_advice, we need to specify the point cut. So how we can specify? Just copy the name of your method. Like this we can specify. So now we are good. We specify the point cut and we wrote our own centralized logging mechanism, right? So let me save this class and let me remove this logging statement from my controller. So if you observe here, in each method we can see one red mark, right? This is what. So if you see this advised by com.javatechie, it is giving the AOP which we wrote here, right? So in each method, each class, you can find this red mark if your point cut is in proper format, so that Spring will give indication to you, this is what we added AOP for you. Okay, so let's run this application first, then we'll verify whether this log statement we are getting in our console or not. Yeah, so let me run this application. Let's open our console. So yeah, let me zoom it. Yeah, so you can see application is up on port 8080, and in our controller we have two rest endpoint. Let me check that. One will save list of product and another one will fetch list of product from database, right? So let's hit this get API first. Go to our postman. Already I configured these two, so go to this get and let's hit this URL. But before that, let me clear the console first so that we can properly check the log statement. Yeah. So now if I will hit this get API, I will get two response, two product object which we added at the time of application load. So you can go to the console. Let me show you that. Yeah. So if you observe here, we are able to see our log statement, right? Method invoke, then the class name is our product controller and the method is get products. As this is the get API, you don't have any argument here. Similarly, next control goes to our product service, then find all product, right? And then we got the response one, product service, then it call find all product service and it give us the response, these two object. Similarly, the response is going back to the controller and we can see this two product object, right? Now what we can do, let's hit our post API. So let me show you. In post, again I am going to add two object, already two product object we have, and I am going to add two more object, right? So let me hit this API. Yeah, so this two product object got added. Let's go to our Eclipse console. Let me show you that. So you can check the next line, method invoked class, then our controller, product controller, then it call save product method, and the argument which we are giving as in postman, we are able to log them, right? This is what the two product we are going to add, and then the same control goes to our product service and it call add product method. Then in database it call save all method and we are able to see the response as well, product service, product controller, this is what the response, right? The same log statement we added in our logging advice. Let me show you that. Yeah, this is what we wrote for method invoked. Then after method invoked, we call this proceeding join point dot proceed. Then we are able to capture the response. So now if I will hit my get API again, I should see the four product object. Yeah, we are getting four product object. So same we can find in our console. Get products of our controller and this is what the response with four product object, right? So this is how we can centralize our logging mechanism. Instead of writing log statement in code itself, we can separate by creating one advice layer and we wrote our log statement, so that the secondary logic which is our logging mechanism, we can segregate from our primary business. Okay. Yeah, so that's how we can use Spring AOP for customize your logging API. Yeah, that's it about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video.